Hearing so many stories about the way Polybius and other video games affected the minds of the player has me on edge. But it's led to this singular moment. My opportunity to manipulate the gaming system. In this virtual reality experience, it's not your head movement or eyes that controls gameplay. It's your actual brainwaves. Sensors on the back of my scalp detect areas of greater activity, and if I think hard enough, I can make things happen, almost like telekinesis.
All right, let's start the adventure. You are escaping a government facility, and all you have is your telekinetic powers. It's an escape the room game with your brain.
Wait, this is not a test. You need to escape from here. Remember, your new powers allow you to perform actions using your mind.
So there's objects on the ground. Feel free to focus on one of them, and it should come to you as soon as you want it.
I did.
And then focus on one of those green circles, and as soon as you consciously want it, it should activate. And that's a code that you can actually use to escape your cell. There is no timers or anything like that. As soon as you consciously want it, we're able to actually do the action. In this next section, you have to battle robots using your brain activity. So just focus on what you want to throw, consciously want it, and you should be able to trigger the action. And then these lasers are actually coming at you, and you can transform them using your brain activity. Good job. This next section, this dog is going to come to attack you, and you have to use your telekinetic powers to transform him.
That's ridiculous.
Good job, look at that. There you go, you just played a game with your brain.
Wow. That is strange. Where is all of this going?
This is the first natural form of human telekinesis. The way we see it working is as technology becomes more mobile, so you're wearing a pair of glasses, for example, that have built-in displays. You can now control them using your mind.
So, okay, eventually you'll have those telekinetic powers as opposed to using a controller to operate something.
Exactly.
I'm just blown away. Seeing through a window into the future, like where this could go, what the possibilities are with it. It's just occurring to me what can be done and what will be done with this. So I'm blown away. That was weird. My imagination is running wild right now, to tell you the truth. It's amazing. You know, the future I imagined and read about as a child is happening right now. It feels like the very beginning of something that is going to be all over the world. It will be in every home, and there's going to be so many uses for it that are positive and beneficial. But, you know, my imagination always goes to what villain could get their hands on this technology and use it for their own purposes, because I know of government programs and technologies that did exist for nefarious purposes.
I started this mission by exploring the legend of Polybius. But my investigation has led me down an unexpected path to question the future of gaming and the very nature of our existence. As I've discovered, video game technology could become so immersive, you might no longer be able to distinguish the virtual world from reality. Is it possible we're player characters living inside a game simulation?
We are about to talk to a guy named Jim Elvidge. He's a futurist, technologist, he has a master's degree in electrical engineering. More importantly, he's an author, and he's written about a real wild idea. Do you believe that it's possible that games themselves are manipulated by some parts of the government for the purposes of mind control?
There could be a nefarious mind behind the video game creation, absolutely. Could the government have been behind it? I wouldn't put it past them. You know, I know the government has been involved in secret projects, you know, mind control experiments and things like that. But it's all within our apparent physical reality. What I'm talking about is something deeper.
You wrote a book. It's kind of a wild theory, but some very brilliant minds believe it to be true. Can you tell me about your book and what this theory is?
The first one was called The Universe Solved. My theory is deep down, our reality is digital. It starts to sound like The Matrix. It starts to sound like something like that.
You believe we are living in a simulation right now?
Yeah, so the word simulation is a very charged word. To me, a simulation conjures up something artificial. Do I believe that we're living in a construct that is programmable, that is malleable, that we can play out simulations and things like that? Yeah, I do.
Who is in control of the digital simulation?
So there are a lot of theories on this. In the simulation theory space, there are ideas like it's us in the future that created these simulations that we're living in. That's Nick Bostrom and Elon Musk believe that.
Elon Musk says that the idea of a simulation is very real. And that the games we play might be completely indistinguishable from reality.
There are others that believe the universe was created by a physicist hacker, you know, from another planet. So maybe it's an alien, or it was an AI that created the whole thing. I think it's more of a big system of information. That's all that there is in, I don't even want to use the word universe, because what we think of as the universe is just in this, quote, simulation.
So our entire solar system, our galaxy, billions of other solar systems and galaxies that are out there are all part of this simulation,
yes.
Then?
Yeah.
Yeah. Some might listen to this and think that we're just like, you know, some kind of sim program, like
right.
We're just in digits.
It doesn't mean it's not, that life isn't beautiful, or that a rose doesn't smell good, or that you can't feel emotions. It's not a cold, calculating thing like we're a program running in a laptop. We're talking about the deep, deep nature of reality here.
I think it would scare a lot of people.
It does.
It would terrify a lot of people.
I think it's more terrifying to think it's lights out when you die. But the idea that there's something else, that your consciousness lives on, is actually very enlightening.